Hello everyone. This PPT is about organizational attitude. So let's start. These are the agendas. First one is nature and dimensions of attitude. So let's go. What is attitude? The attitude is the evaluative statements or judgments concerning objects, people or events. More precisely, the attitudes can be defined as a persistent tendency to feel and behave in a particular way towards some object, which may include events or individuals as well. Characteristics of attitudes. They tend to persist unless something is done to change them. They can fall anywhere along a continuum from very favorable to very unfavorable. They are directed toward some object about which a person has feelings and beliefs. Types of attitudes: job satisfaction, job involvement, organizational commitment. Job satisfaction is a collection of positive and or negative feelings that an individual holds toward his or her job. Job involvement is identifying with the job, actively participating in it and considering performance importance to self-worth. Organizational commitment, identifying with a particular organization and its goal and wishing to maintain membership in the organization. The nature and dimensions of attitude. These are the components of attitude: emotional, informational, behavioral. Components of attitudes. Attitudes have three components: affective component, behavioral component, and cognitive component. Affective component, this involves a person's feeling or emotion about the attitude object. For example, I'm scared of spiders. Behavioral component, the way the attitude we have influences how we act or behave. For example, I will avoid spider and scream if I see one. Cognitive attitude, this involves person's belief or knowledge about an attitude or objective. For example, I believe spiders are dangerous. This model is known as the ABC model of attitude. The three components are usually linked. However, there is evidence that cognitive and affective components of behavior do not allow match with behavior. The evaluate statements in an attitude are either favorable or unfavorable. They reflect how one feels about something. The person can have thousands of attitudes, but OB focuses on a limited number of job-related attitudes. These include job satisfaction, job involvement, and organizational commitment. Formation of attitude. So how attitudes are formed? How do you develop your attitude? Essentially, attitudes are the outward manifestation of your inner values and beliefs. These develop over time. As you grow, you watch the significant people around you behaving in a particular way. You are being told to cherish certain things over others, and you learn from your teachers and peers and come to value certain things over others, thus forming your value system. These in turn give rise to development of your attitude. Attitude help predict work behavior. The following example might help to illustrate it. After introducing a particular policy, it is found from an attitude survey that the workers are not too happy about it. During the subsequent week, it is found that the attendance of the employee drops sharply from the previous standard. Here, management may conclude that a negative attitude toward new work rule led to increased absenteeism. Attitudes help people to adapt to their work environment. An understanding of attitudes is also very important because attitude helps the employees to get adjusted to their work. If the management can successfully develop a positive attitude among the employees, they will be better adjusted to their work. process of formation of attitude, social learning. It is acquiring attitude from others. There are broadly three processes of acquiring attitudes through social learning: classical conditioning, instrumental conditioning, and modeling. So classical conditioning is a basic form of learning in which one stimulus regularly precedes another. Instrumental conditioning conditioning is concerned with learning to express the right views. Modeling as a concept deal with individuals acquiring new behavior through observing the action of others. Individuals tend to do what others do, not what others say. Thus, attitudes may be transmitted from one person to another, or from one group to other, or from one generation to another generation. Direct experience. Attitudes are also formed through real life experience, which may be also called as direct experience or personal experience. Various studies suggest that strength of attitudes acquired through direct experience is stronger than the strength of attitudes acquired indirectly. Attitudes acquired through direct experience are held more confidently and are more difficult to be subjected to change. If we hold strong attitude about an object, issue, or a person, and you want others to properly understand your stand, it is better to let others have direct experience with the attitude object. Functions of attitude. According to Katz, attitudes serve four important functions from the viewpoint of organizational behavior. These are the adjustment function. Attitudes often help people to adjust to their work environment. Well-treated employees tend to develop a positive attitude towards their job, management, and organization in general, while treated and ill-treated organizational member develop a negative attitude. Ego defensive function. Attitude helps people to retain their dignity and self-image. When a young faculty member who is full of fresh ideas and enthusiasm joins the organization, the old members might feel somewhat threatened by him, but they tend to disapprove his creative idea as crazy and impractical and dismiss him altogether. The value expressive function. Attitude provides individual with a basis for expressing their values. For example, a manager who values hard and sincere work will be more vocal against an employee who is having very casual approach toward work. The knowledge function. Attitude provides the standard and frames of reference that allow people to understand and perceive the world around him. If one has strong negative attitude toward the management, whatever the management does, even the employee welfare programs can be perceived as something bad and as actually against them. Measurement of attitude. Leica's method. It has five parameters. These parameters are strongly agree, undecided, that means neutral, disagree, and strongly disagree. So this is overall summary. Attitudes traditionally have been described as a process in which we logically calculate our feelings towards the attitude object based on an analysis of our beliefs. Thus, beliefs predict feelings, which predict behavioral intentions, which predict behavior, but this traditional perspective overlooks the role of emotions, which have an important influence on attitude and behavior. Behavior sometimes influence our subsequent attitude through cognitive dissonance. People also have personality traits which affect their emotions and attitude. Thank you so much for